cannot get played for shit that a nigga really didn't even what nigga do? Did dirt with the blanks on the whole crew. I feel like OJ and Rodney, a little male, but still don't be having no happy days like Roxy. Niggas get blamed for everything, from robbing your house to whole shows and the trafficking of cocaine. And if the sun turns black,
yup, a nigga did a gym.
Or
getting over here, so I can blame it on him.
Niggas get niggas like the oldies. Play the fuck out, we only know for stealing cars and drinking police now. I'm showing your whole ass cracked on cops. They quick to do a nigga on the...
All right. Aside from the light mood of music, I got a problem. We all got a problem. And something needs to be done. Who else fell in the golf? Nothing's being done. Nothing at all is being done. You know, we hear about it every day in the news, but people are not getting pissed off enough about this. Before I go any further, I want to take this moment to tell anybody and everybody in the U.S. who's watching this video right now and who may agree with me. Pick up a piece of paper. Pick up a pen. Write your congressman. Now, a lot of us have shitty handwriting, so if you can't do that, type a letter out, print it, mail it. Not email it, none of that shit. Like real postal mail, send it to them. Make them have a hard copy of it. You know, let them know how you feel. Of course, don't be talking like it's me and you or you and your buddies or some shit. Don't be talking like that, but make sure you get your point across. Let these guys know that we have problems in this country. Unless something at least gets started, at least something needs to be done. Something needs to get started. There needs to be a starting point for our country to heal itself. Okay? Let them know they're not going to get reelected. You're not going to vote for them again if nothing gets done. Because while Obama could have done more for this oil spill, it should have been prevented in the first place from, I don't know, 20, 30 years ago, when the same people who regulate this oil business are in bed with the people in the oil business itself. Because there is no regulation. I mean, you got regulators working for the oil company. It's ridiculous, and it's a completely ridiculous system. Do any kind of in-depth research on this, and you'll find that the people who are supposed to be regulating oil are actually paid by oil. They need to break the companies down because they have safety and profit companies under the same fucking umbrella. They need to split them up forcibly if need be. At least here. At least do what we can do. This is beyond ridiculous. This is a disaster. Listen to me. This is a disaster. Okay? Exxon Valdez what? It was a big deal then, man. This needs to be a much bigger deal. I know we see it in the news every day, and, you know, I don't watch regular news, and I suggest everybody and anybody in the U.S., or anybody, period, that gets this channel, Fox News, block it. It's the most ridiculous news network I've ever fucking seen in my life. Fox News. Don't watch Fox News. Now, their comedy department is a whole other story, and actually they're separate, so you can watch the... I watch Family Guy and shit. But anyway, don't watch these guys. This news broadcast shit is so completely biased and one-sided and ridiculous. It's a news program front for the conservatives. Now, I really can't say much news programs have a whole lot of... They don't have much of anything as far as solid news goes. You know, they report, you know, headlines, and they don't really, you know, they don't really get into it. But anything is better than Fox News. I like to watch Anderson Cooper, Rachel Maddow, and my all-time favorite to watch every week is Bill Maher. I know it's a comedy show, but it's more than that. It's a debate show. And I don't care what you think about the guy. Most of the things that come out of that man's mouth makes sense. I am a little pissed off at Obama for not doing more, but at least he's made a step now. And let's stop acting like Obama hasn't been working on this from the beginning. You know, just because we weren't going to get as involved in the beginning doesn't mean he wasn't working on it, or his, you know, his team wasn't working on it. There are federal prosecutors down there now, which there should have been weeks ago. But they're there now, federal prosecutors. Now, to those of you who say, oh, it's no big deal, nothing's going to happen, maybe, maybe not. But it's a step that needed to be get taken. Criminal acts need to be pursued by criminal means. This is the oil spill and terrorism. You can lump in the same boat with this, with this particular idea of criminalization. You know, for the war on terror, we're using the army, which is, I'm sorry, it's fucking dumb to use an army to fight terrorism. It's a criminal act. You use FBI, you use CIA, you use these agencies that deal with criminal acts. You use federal prosecutors. Now, with this oil spill, heads need to start rolling. This has gone on too long. You know, it was bad, now it's worse, and it can only get worse from here. I was watching Rachel Maddow last night, and she's on like a small island. You know, they call it an insignificant island, but they were showing what happens when oil gets in the water and brushes up on this island. It coats the grass, it coats the plants, it basically causes the island to erode because the oil gets in there and weakens the soil. So parts of this island are going to start falling off. What the fuck do you think is going to happen to the coast when it fucking gets deep there? This needs to be handled. Who are they fooling with these solutions to the fucking problem? It's almost as if they want it to keep going. I mean, I cannot fathom, you know, any other place around the world that would have let this just continue and continue and continue. I mean, only in America, right? I mean, I know we were supposed to stay out of it because it wasn't our rig or whatever, but we're using the fucking oil. Get our government behind this. You know, there's some things government's bad for, some things government's good for. This is a good cause for government intervention. Okay, you couldn't ask for a better situation for government to have stepped in and done something right away. Now it may be too little too late. I'm serious. There's a lot of fucking oil out there now. And nothing's, nobody's saying anything. I mean, they're saying the same shit every day. But normal everyday people out on the fucking street hardly fucking care. Like, oh yeah, oil bill is bad. That sucks. What's the next fucking sentence that comes out of their mouth? Gas prices are going to go up again. Motherfucker, that's the least of your worries. Okay, that is the least of your worries. This is a problem. I know not all of us live down there. So maybe some of us feel disconnected from it somehow. We're not disconnected from it. It's affecting our country as a whole. Okay, so anyway, I'm gonna get on here and type up some letters, and then I'm gonna fucking mail them out to my congressmen, to my senators, to my House of Representatives from Indiana, and I'm going to mail them, and I'm gonna mail them every week. Maybe it does something, maybe it doesn't, but I tell you what, mailing letters and shit, expressing how you feel through words that reaches, maybe not the senator himself directly, but at least his aide, or somebody's reading it, okay? If they don't think they're going to get reelected, I know this is a long shot, and people are going to be like, it doesn't matter, it does. It matters very much. These guys gear their whole careers off of reelection, okay? At least it puts it in, you know, puts the sentiment down that we are paying attention. We know what's going on. We know our government's been in bed with oil for years. We know these things. It's ridiculous. It needs to stop now. Dependency on oil needs to stop now. All you drill baby drill motherfuckers that were out there, this is what happens. Get off the oil tit. Because if we don't get off the oil tit, I got news for everybody. it's not going to get no better. It will not get any better than it'll only get worse from here. This is NaptownBorn. Deuces.